are the stories from the road of an automotive diagnostic robot from the future to discover new problems and new vehicles and to go where no other robot has gone before.
Robotech was called to a shop on a 1999 Toyota Corolla with a 1.8-liter engine and a code B0303, or misfire on cylinder number 3. The engine had a slight misfire upon acceleration, and during a preloaded condition. During idle, the engine tended to stay fairly smooth, and ran fine. The shop did not engage in parts changing, and went through all the steps of checking the issue. The shop did replace the spark plugs, but did not have an ignition scope to properly check the high voltage waveform. This engine was a coil-on plug or COP unit, which makes it hard to check ignition. After trying without any success on finding the problem, the shop decided to call me in for assistance. When I got to the shop, the first impulse was to grab the ignition scope, but I am Robotech, I knew better, and stuck to proper procedure. I started my diagnostics by using the scan tool to check codes and do a data stream analysis. I retrieved code B0303, exactly as stated by the tech. I then did a fuel trim analysis and found that, at idle, the air fuel mixture was stable and holding at about ±4%. Then, while in gear and preloading the engine, fuel trims went to +20%. This was an indication of a lean condition or a misfiring cylinder. A misfiring cylinder dumps raw fuel into the exhaust. Incredible as it may seem, the O2 sensor senses this as a lean condition, since it doesn't care about fuel, and only sees the oxygen content in the exhaust. At this time, I was ready to perform an ignition check, using my portable engine analyzer. This was a tough engine to do, since it had coil-on plug, and everything was hidden. But, I had in my possession a capacitive pickup system to capture ignition patterns over the air, with no need for disassembly. This equipment consisted of an amplifier box unit, to amplify the signal, a series of capacitive pickup antennas seen here in green, and the sync probe to set the signal to a specific cylinder. The unit was easy to set up. The amplifier box connected straight to my scope, and had a gain knob to fine-tune the output. As soon as I did the test, I saw a good waveform at idling speeds. Then, as I did a wide-open throttle goose test, I immediately saw the problem. On both, the wide-open throttle and the preloaded test, cylinder number 3 was missing. I could also see that in the ignition pattern indicated that there was plenty of kilovolts present. So, the coil was probably in good condition. All I had to do now was figure out one thing. Was I having a fuel misfire, or an ignition misfire due to a faulty coil boot arching at the spark plug hole? I then decided to pull out an old diagnostic technique. I wanted to do the tests without doing any major disassembly. So, I grabbed the low-pressure transducer that I had made myself, and connected it to the scope. The vacuum hose at the pressure transducer was then connected to the fuel pressure regulator. The technique involved detecting the minor fluctuations in fuel pressure at the pressure regulator rubber diaphragm. I had used this technique many times over, with good results. As I did the test, I noticed that cylinder number 3 was giving me no pressure drop upon preloading the engine. This indicated that the number 3 injector was semi-clogged, or there was a problem with the injector coil winding. Whatever the reason, this injector was faulty. Rather than remove and test the injector, which was probably the ultimate test, but very time-consuming, I decided to just replace the injector. So, I instructed the tech to replace the injector, and the vehicle was never seen again. Later tests on the old injector proved that in fact it wasn't clogged, but had a mechanical issue with its needle valve or plantel. The idea behind the techniques I used was to minimize disassembly as much as possible, while determining the root cause of the problem. The pressure transducer gadget I used was easy to make, with parts readily available.
This robot will now power down for a recharge. Will I dream? I don't know. See you next time.